Hello everyone, I am Chef Umesh from Chitkara School of Hospitality, and today we are going to read about the chapter Sauce Cookery Part 1. The objectives of reading this chapter is to know about what is a sauce, functions of sauce, components which are used in making a sauce, classification of different sauce, and storage and precautions while preparing a sauce and storing it. So before we move, we must know that a good sauce is that which makes excellent food look still better. A sauce creation calls up for precision and knowledge gained from experience, exercise with patience and disciplined attention. A keen sense of smell, a delicate sense of taste, a light, strong hand for the blending all must contribute to the perfect sauce. One of the person named Grimaud de la Rouye said that the sauce is to culinary art what grammar is to language. Other person coined a phrase which is also famous nowadays, and that is what poetry is to the prose, the sauce is to the food. Sauce in Latin also means salis, which is term for salt. As most of the sauce are savory, that is the reason salis in Latin is known as sauce in European countries. If we have to define a sauce, we can say that sauce are liquid or semi-liquid mixtures which is added to meat, poultry, fish, vegetables and dessert. What does it do? It provides moisture or richness to the food. It is also an ingredient which gives moisture or provides garnish or to otherwise enhance the appearance of the food. In some cases, the sauces also adds in the nutritional value of the food. But more importantly, the principal purpose of a sauce is to add or enhance the flavor of the food. Mother sauces date back to the 18th century, when lack of refrigeration caused foods to spoil much faster. Sauces were often used to cover up the flavor of less than perfect meats, poultry and seafood. Most of the mother sauces that we know were initially invented by French chefs, for example, Antoine Marie Carême, Auguste Escoffier, and so the French nomenclature and classification is usually followed while talking about the sauce. If we go to the functions of sauces, they provide moisture, enhances flavor, provide richness, improves appearance, provides interest and appetite appeal to the food. Discussing them in brief is that sometimes sauces are used to add a contrast in taste to another food. Apple sauce with fresh roast pork serves the same purpose. Broadly speaking, any condiment or mixture of food which serves to contrast with or complement another food can be termed as a sauce. Similarly, some sauces are used to add sharpness or tanginess to a bland food. A remoulade is a perfect example, which is served with shrimp, and it is a piquant sauce which is quite juicy. Sauces may add to the appearance of food, sometimes as a coating which is poured or brushed over the food to give a pleasing appearance to an otherwise uninteresting item. The choufroid sauce, made with a cream or mayonnaise and gelatin, is used to coat various food items. Sauces such as barbecue sauce are used to modify the original flavor of a food, blending the sauce flavor with the flavor of the food. Some sauces are used to disguise or mask the original flavor of the food. A similar example that we do in bakeries is that to mask the flavor of egg, we usually add vanilla essence to it. Similarly, some sauces in French culinary also are used to mask the food. In regard to the sauces, masking a food with a jelly or sauce is to completely cover it, physically hiding its appearance. Masking does not change the true flavor of the food. Other thing is that sauces should never be used to change the flavor of a food material. It should be only used to enhance or to complement the flavor of the food. Moving to next slide, if we talk about components of sauce, these are liquid, which may be a stock, milk, water, fat, etc. Thickening, which may be a slurry, roux, paste, etc. Seasoning, salt, pepper, spices, and flavoring agents like herbs and spices binded in a bouquet garni. Sauce classification. Moving ahead, sauces may be classified by several ways. One of the system is that by serving temperature, warm or cold, by flavor, bluntness or piquancy, by acidity, by sweetness, by color, and by base, whether it is a neutral or a meat-based sauce. As per diagrammatically, sauce can be classified as proprietary and preparatory. Proprietary sauces are those which are made by owners or held in private ownership, or manufacture and sale of which is restricted by a patent. Preparatory sauces are those which are made by chefs. Proprietary sauce denotes sauces that are not made in kitchen but can be purchased from a market. They are imported or procured locally. They have a unique taste which cannot be reproduced by anybody. It has a secret recipe guarded by the patents. They are multi-purpose in their use. Some of the examples of proprietary sauces are tomato ketchup, HP sauce, Tabasco sauce, Worcestershire sauce, English mustard sauce, etc. Whereas preparatory sauces are those which are very much made in the kitchen by following standard recipe and traditional guidelines, depending upon the style of making, they are classified as follows. Starting from sauce, there could be a contemporary sauce or mother sauce and its derivative sauce and non-derivative sauce. About the details of mother sauce and their derivatives and contemporary sauce, we will discuss it in our next chapter. In this chapter, we'll be just checking out a brief of these mother sauce. Now, mother sauce can be further classified as thickened sauce, under which comes bechamel, espagnole, tomato sauce, and velouté sauce. Under the emulsified sauce, we can count hollandaise and mayonnaise. There are some other sauce like hot butter sauce and hard butter sauce, which comes under different category, but they are not counted as mother sauces. Here we have a diagram depicting different colors of different sauce, starting from velouté, which is a brown color, bechamel, which is white in color, tomato, which is red in color, hollandaise, yellowish, it is taking the color of yolk, which is the main ingredient which is used to prepare it, espagnole, shiny brown color. If we have to know about the functions of the sauce in culinary work, we can say that sometimes sauces are used to add contrast in taste to another food. Sometimes they provide sharpness or tanginess. Sometimes they also increase the appearance of the major food. They also modify the original flavor, etc. Here we have some sauce and their derivative, starting from bechamel, which is a white sauce, which is made by the help of milk and roux, and there are certain derivatives starting from cream, cheddar, mornay, nantua or soubi. About all these sauces we are going to read in our next part. In this next slice we have velouté sauce, which is a combination of stock and roux. Then comes espagnole, which is made by brown stock plus brown roux. And the last is hollandaise, which is made by the help of butter and egg yolk. Tomato sauce is also a sauce considered under mother sauces, which is made up of tomato plus vegetable puree. In our last slide, we will read about storage and precautions of sauces, which start from that highly perishable sauce should be contained or preserved under the temperature of 5 degrees Celsius to 60 degrees Celsius. We already know that all the sauces are highly perishable because of the presence of water, proteins and carbohydrates, which favor the growth of bacteria, yeast and mold. The danger zone, as it is known, is 5 degrees to 60 degrees Celsius or 65 degrees Celsius in some countries. So we must take care that we would not keep our sauce in between these temperatures. The total time in the danger zone, including cooling and preheating times, must be less than 2 hours. About the storage of sauce, all sauces with the exception of butter-based emulsion sauces should be stored below 4 degrees Celsius and covered all the time. Storage time should be less than 1 week. Storage times of frozen sauces should not exceed 6 months and ideally should be used under the 3 months. Sauces should be stored in sanitized containers. It is better to use several smaller sealed containers than a single large one. If the sauces are to be frozen, then they can be packed in sealed plastic bags under vacuum or placed in sealed metal or plastic containers. All those containers must be labeled and dated, and a record should be kept separately of what or which type of sauce is stored. As with the storage of stocks, a cartouche, which is a paper based helpful, arrangement in which a paper is usually used to trap the steam, may be used to cover sauces, although plastic cling wrap and containers with lids are also acceptable. As we know, roux based sauces will form a skin on the top, and a cartouche can be used to assist in keeping this soft and minimal. In major cases, the example is bechamel sauce, which may have dabs of butter placed over the surface whilst hot to stop skinning, but a cartouche is best for it. If we have to reconstitute our already prepared sauce, then it can be done by reheating or adding some more water to it or hot water to it. We must also take care that we need not to overheat our sauce because it may burn it. Sauces can be reheated in covered shallow trays in a hot oven to minimize the likelihood of burning and when stovetops are not in use. During service, hot sauce must be held above 65 degrees Celsius, and at the end of the service, the reheated sauce should be discarded, as should any sauce brought out of bulk storage. Flour and roux based sauce will reconstitute but may require some adjustment when reheated. If possible, modified starch should be substituted for flour or flour. There are some differences between reconstituting soups and sauces. Soups are adjusted for consistency and flavor only when the entire soup has been fully reheated to at least 80 degrees Celsius. With this slide, we would end our topic, Sauces Part 1. For any queries, you may reach out to me at umesh.chugran@chitkara.edu.in. Thank you.